Hello, tiny humans, and welcome back to Art at Home with Miss Wilkin. So, today we are going to be making our project that goes along with the book that we read, Dragons Love Tacos. And, of course, we're going to be making a taco. So, I'm going to show you guys my happy taco, and then I will show you guys how to make your own. So, here's my happy taco, and I filled it with all the ingredients that I like. I also wrote a note on the inside. I'll show you guys how you can make these open up like cards, or how you can close them like this and just make them one single taco picture. So, what you're gonna need is two pieces of paper. It can be colored paper or it can be white paper. I'm using white paper and I'm gonna color everything in myself. But if you have paper that matches the colors of your ingredients here, you can use that instead. So, you need two pieces of paper. You're gonna need a pair of scissors, some glue, either wet glue or a glue stick, and then something to draw or color with. I'm gonna be using markers today. So, let's get started. So, like I said, you're gonna need two pieces of paper, your scissors, your glue, something to color or draw with, and that's about it. I'm gonna have my little taco guy sitting over here so that we can take a look at him as we go. So, what you're gonna do is take one of your pieces of paper, set the other one off to the side, and you're gonna fold your piece of paper in half like you're making a birthday card. So the short side is gonna touch the short side. Gonna fold it down. Good, now let's look at the shape of our taco. I want my taco to be able to open up, at least when I start. So I'm gonna need it to have two sides, kind of like this card. And the taco is a half circle. So what we're gonna do is draw a half circle on our paper and cut it out. Now, we need to make sure that our half circle is drawn on the side where the fold is. If I'm drawing my half circle on this side, when I cut it out, I'm gonna end up with two pieces. If I cut it on this side, I'm gonna end up with something that folds open. So I'm gonna draw my taco shape. And I'm gonna use as much of my paper as I can. Perfect. And then I'm gonna cut it out. But I'm gonna make sure that it's folded closed so that I'm cutting both sides at the same time. Awesome, so now I've got my taco shell and I can put all my ingredients on the inside. So let's talk about what we like to have in our tacos. If we think about our Dragons Love Tacos books, we remember that the dragons did not like spicy things in their tacos at all. But these tacos aren't for them. These tacos are for us. So you can put whatever you want in your taco. I put spicy peppers in my taco because I like to have spicy peppers in mine. Now, I could never ever give this taco to a dragon. It would be very, 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 very spicy. So you guys can put whatever you like in your tacos. I'm gonna show you how to draw a couple different things that you might usually find in some tacos. So once you get your second piece of paper, I'm gonna start with some lettuce because I like lettuce in my tacos. And I'm gonna draw the lettuce as big pieces so that it's easier for us to cut out. Awesome, so lettuce leaves do not have to all be perfect shapes. We're gonna end up gluing them over top of each other a little bit so they can be a little bit more funky than they might normally be. Because once we color them in, you'll be able to tell that they are the leaves of my lettuce. The second thing that I usually put in my tacos is tomatoes. And I think it's a lot easier to draw tomatoes as big slices because we already know how to draw those circles and wheel shapes. So I'm gonna draw a couple tomato slices. And you notice I'm drawing with my black marker and then I'm gonna go back in and color everything in once I draw. Something else that I like on my tacos is beans or meat. Some of you guys like meat on your tacos. Some of you might like beans on your tacos. I'm gonna show you a way to draw it so that it could be either. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my taco shell. I'm gonna kind of measure it against my paper to see. I'm gonna need quite a long piece to make it look like there's meat or beans in the bottom of my taco, right? So I'm gonna use this long piece that I have open at the bottom to draw this sort of lumpy squiggle shape. Like that. Good. Then, if I look at my example over here, I'm still missing a couple things. I had some beans here, but we've got that down here. And I also have some jalapeno peppers. If you guys like spicy things, you can add a couple little pepper slices, which are just little circles that will color green. And then I also like cheese on my tacos. So I'm gonna do kind of a similar thing that I did down here for my beans or my meat. And I'm gonna draw this sort of lumpy shape or lumped shapes for my cheese to color in. Awesome. Now, of course, if there's anything else that you guys like to put on your tacos that I didn't draw here, you can add that as well. So now I'm gonna go back and add the color, and then I'm gonna add some details to my little pieces to make them look a little bit more like the ingredients that I'm trying to make. All right, so once I've got all of my ingredients all colored in, you'll notice that I added some little lines inside some of my food items to make them look a little bit more like the food that I'm trying to make. So I added some little V shapes inside this tomato here to make it kind of look like the inside of a tomato. And I added some little wrinkles to my lettuce. Now, all I'm gonna do is cut them all out. All right, so once you've got all of your ingredients all cut out, we are gonna add one more thing to the front of our taco before we add all of our ingredients on the inside. So taco shells are usually like a light brown or an almost yellow color. With markers, it's kind of hard to find an in-between color like that. So I'm just gonna use a regular yellow and I'm gonna add some little brown dots around. But before I do that, I want to draw my face, because if I add my yellow all the way across, you won't be able to see these cute little white highlights in our taco's eyes. So I'm going to draw my face first. This is totally optional, which means if you don't want to draw a face on your taco, you do not have to. Start with two big eyes, and I'm going to draw a little circles inside of them like this, and that's where those really fun little white highlights come from that make our taco look extra cute. We'll give him some eyebrows, and I like to give him a big happy mouth.
And then I usually draw his tongue like that. Awesome. And then I'll color in the eyes. Great, so now that we've got our face, we can color in the taco shell around it. All right, so now my taco's all colored in, I'm gonna add my ingredients on the inside. So I'm gonna open them up like this, and with my glue stick, I like to lay everything out first and see if I like it. Beans. Ooh, it's a little bit too short, but that's okay. What I'll do is actually cut my beans, or my meat, if this is what you guys are using that as, into smaller pieces, and then I can arrange them like this so they stick out the side. Lettuce. Good. And then I'll start sticking my things down. Now, this is when you can decide if you would like your taco to be able to open so you can write a note on the inside, or if you want to close it and glue it shut so it's just a taco picture. Awesome. So since I made this taco openable, right, so I can open it up and write in it, I'm going to make this one so it's just a closed taco picture. So all I'm going to do differently is when I'm done gluing everything down, I'm going to go ahead and put glue on the back of my taco's face and close them up.
Are very happy tacos. I would love to see what you guys create, and I would love to see what other kind of stuff you like to put in your tacos. So send me pictures. Definitely take a look at the story if you didn't hear me reading it. And I can't wait to see you guys. Bye, tiny humans.